Hi everyone. We've been talking a lot about Mary. We've been talking about the different things that we observe in Scripture about her character and about the things that she did and her attitude that was displayed that showed us her godliness and her willingness to be used by God. And I think if we were to look at all the different things that we've talked about so far, and if we were to consider how we could kind of tie it all in together, I think there's just a couple of common things that overlap all of these different traits that we've looked at. I think first one, it would be surrendered. Mary was somebody who was surrendered, and so she was surrendered at the beginning when God initially spoke to her, and she was surrendered when she had to trust God to speak to Joseph, and she was surrendered when, you know, she had to go through the actual childbirth and the difficult circumstances with that, and she was surrendered all the way through as Jesus grew up, and she considered and pondered and meditated on the things that she was seeing happen in her life and in Jesus's life. And I think we also would say, though, that Mary was not just surrendered, but she was faithful. And her faithfulness is what allowed her to be so greatly used by God. She was a very devoted woman. She was devoted from the time that we first read about her in the beginning of the Christmas story, all the way through Jesus's life, and then we see her at the cross. See, Mary wasn't just devoted when it was easy to be devoted. She didn't just follow when it was convenient to follow. She was faithfully devoted to the very end, even in dangerous circumstances, even in difficulty, even in pain. And I think a lot of us want to be devoted women. We want to be faithful. We want to be committed to Christ. We don't always follow through the way that we should, because it's easy to get distracted by the things of the world. It's easy to get frustrated because things aren't improving as quickly or in the ways that we would like. And it's easy to give up when we begin to experience friction and pushback. And sometimes that pushback comes from the world. Sometimes it comes from other Christians. Sometimes it can even come within our own families. And yet Mary was someone who was faithful and devoted even amidst a great danger to herself. She was there when other people turned on Jesus. She was there when people complained about him. She was there when his own siblings didn't believe him. She was there through the end. Now, obviously, she had some hiccups because there were times when she said he was out of his mind. But when we see Jesus on the cross, we also see Mary at the foot of the cross. And so she overcame those difficulties. She persevered and she was devoted and faithful to Jesus all the way. Even after Jesus went back to heaven, we read of Mary being faithful with the believers. And so when we look at our own lives, the questions for us to consider today are, am I devoted? Do I follow Jesus when it's hard? Or do I only follow Jesus when it's easy? Do I follow Jesus when things are going my way? Or do I follow him when things maybe aren't so much going my way and I have to have the faith to wait and see what he's going to do? Am I willing to persevere to the end in order to receive that prize? Or am I guilty of giving up when I begin to face difficulty and when it gets hard? Unfortunately, our culture works hard to make our following of Jesus difficult. And we don't even live overseas where people are facing intense persecution. We just have the difficulty of the culture that promotes instant gratification. And that instant gratification mindset is transferred to our relationship with God. And we can fall into that trap of believing that if I'm going to follow Jesus, then things are immediately going to get better. And sometimes they don't. If I'm going to follow Jesus, then everything's going to go really well and quite easily and smoothly for the rest of my life. And that's not always the case. And so when we begin to struggle, we're tempted to give up. But let's not give up. Let's be committed to be faithful and devoted to Jesus to the end, having the faith to believe that what he has is better, what he has is worth it, and that if we can persevere to the end, we will receive the crown of life that he has promised.